In the previous videos, we pointed out single and hybrid bus layouts for DC microgrids. In this video, we finalize this week by addressing the bipolar single bus DC microgrid. The main learning objective will fall under four main questions. First, how a bipolar DC microgrid is created. Second, what are the main advantages and disadvantages of a bipolar layout? Third, what are the grid feeding and grid forming components in a bipolar microgrid? And fourth, what are the DC voltage levels in a single bus, hybrid and bipolar DC microgrids? The slides show a schematic diagram of a single bus bipolar DC microgrid. As detailed before, the bipolar connection has two low voltage conductors with opposite polarities using one or both ends. If both ends are grounded, then each link can be independently operated and controlled. In the figure, one monopolar DC bus on the left is connected to a bipolar DC bus on the right. In the monopolar DC link on the left, the main grid is connected through a three-phase, three-leg voltage source inverter or AC to DC converter. The battery bank is connected to the monopolar DC link with a buck and boost DC-DC converter. Also, the diesel or gas generator is connected to the DC link via a three-phase AC-DC inverter. On the other hand side, the bipolar DC link is also connected to an external electrical network through an AC-DC inverter, voltage source inverter, while the AC loads are connected through a three-phase, three-leg AC-DC inverter. The DC loads and the photovoltaic solar unit are connected with a boost converter to bipolar DC link. It is worth mentioning that a voltage balance topology can be used to balance the voltages across the bipolar DC link. In other words, it intends to bring two pole to ground voltages at bipolar type at the same levels, same values. The topology of voltage balances is based on the one switch based leg and a capacitor leg, which are connected through an inductor. If an unbalanced voltage is occurring, then two switches are controlled in such a way that the current will flow through the inductor. As a result, the voltage of capacitors can be constantly controlled and adjusted. In this slide, we can see the grid forming and grid feeding representation of the DC microgrid from the previous slides. At the monopolar single bus on the left side, both AC grids, AC utility mains and battery stack are able to control the DC link voltage. If the grid is strong, then it is typically the best choice to control the monopolar DC link voltage. However, if the grid is weak, then the battery bank or diesel gas generator can be used to regulate the monopolar DC voltage. At the bipolar DC link on the right, PV solar units, AC loads and DC loads are all represented by grid feeding or current source with parallel impedances. The bipolar DC link can be controlled by the AC grid on the right or by the monopolar DC link on the left. It is worth mentioning that the voltage balancer can be represented as a voltage source which balances the voltage drop or increase across the bipolar DC link. The bipolar single bus DC microgrid has some important advantages. First of all, due to the presence of AC grid at both monopolar and bipolar links, the DC link voltage can be better regulated in a more stable way. And thanks to the voltage balancer, the voltage imbalances over the bipolar DC link can be satisfactorily mitigated. Also, thanks to the presence of the grid forming components at both monopolar and bipolar sides, the controllability and also the reliability is higher, for instance, in the case that one of the grids fails. In spite of all these advantages, the overall efficiency is lower compared to a hybrid bus, as no AC bus is present and AC components like the diesel generator or gas generator and AC loads are unavoidably connected through AC to DC converters. In this slide, we provide a summary of voltage level for all the previously discussed DC layouts. The typical voltages for a single bus with direct battery connections are 12, 24, and 48 volts. Note that the DC link voltage of this single bus layout is dependent on the state of charge of the battery. Therefore, not very high DC link voltages can be necessarily achieved. In a single bus with indirect battery, the typical DC voltages are 24, 48, and even high values like 380 volt. In this layout, a boost converter topology can be used to step up the voltage of the battery to the high DC link values. A hybrid bus may operate at lower voltages like 48 or higher ones like 380 volt. Typical voltage levels for a bipolar bus would be 170, 75 volt and 340, 350 volt. Well, today we address the advantages and disadvantages of a bipolar single bus topology and detail the topology of a voltage balancer for such layout. Also, we close the video with a summary of typical voltage levels for all the previously mentioned layouts.